Good morning, students. So as it is clear from the screen, you people might have been able to make out, like today we are going to start with a new chapter, The Ailing Planet, The Green Movement's Role. So this chapter written by Nani Palkiwala. So this ailing planet, so first of all, like which planet we are going to talk about in this chapter? It's the very Earth where we live. So it's the planet Earth which is being referred to as ailing. Ailing means sick, not healthy. So our planet Earth is now sick. It's not well. It's not healthy. So this chapter actually is very, very, you know, it's a burning topic of the day, and we can say, because it's the like very, it's the base, it's a root of all the problems which we people are facing nowadays. So the most relevant, I guess, this is the most relevant topic which we people all have been discussing and need to discuss also right now. So for the last 1.5 years, we people have been all stuck up because of this kind of pandemic. And this 1 year has made all of us, this has forced us to think about like how we people have been treating or had been treating our Mother Earth, how we people had been treating our nature. So as it is said, like what we sow, so we get back. Okay, whatever we get, whatever the result is, that is all because of what we do. So what we people have given to our Mother Earth, it's giving us back now, isn't it? So this chapter, The Ailing Planet, it was written sometimes in 1994. This chapter was written by Nani Palkiwala in 1994. This article was written in 1994 and was published then in one of the newspapers, Indian Express. So almost about 30 years ago, this chapter was written, this article was written. And at that time, already at that time, the condition of this planet was very miserable. But during these 30 years, no one actually paid much heed to what Nani Palkiwala was saying. It was not only Nani Palkiwala. There were so many other environmentalists, those who had been talking and actively, you know, making the inhabitants of this earth aware of the necessity to take care of the Mother Earth. But had the efforts been from everyone, from each one of us, then maybe we would not have been the witness to what we are witnessing nowadays. So had the things been improved, had the situation been better, had we people been able to take care of our Mother Earth, had we people adopted the measures which we people need to adopt even now, then maybe the things would have been better, isn't it? So now right now the point is that the planet, our Mother Earth, is suffering. It's not hale and hearty. So if the planet Earth is not hale and hearty, there must be some symptoms. So when somebody is not well, when we are not well, when we think that we are not hale and hearty, we feel some symptoms. What symptoms we feel? What is a symptom which makes us feel that we are not well? The very first symptom which comes up is like we feel that we have fever. You know, our body temperature starts rising up. Okay, our body temperature starts rising from the normal one, right? And so the moment we feel like having fever or that high temperature, that is having a fever or temperature in itself is no problem. But having fever is an indication that there is something wrong with the body, that there is something wrong with some system of the body. So when we have fever, we just don't get medicine to cure us of fever. We have to go for the root of fever, and that root the doctor examines, right? So similarly, it is the case with Mother Earth also. So right now, the Mother Earth is not well. The symptom is global warming. Okay, we all talk about global warming. We all talk about extreme weather conditions. In the winters, the winter season is extreme. In the summer season is extreme. The rainy season is also becoming extreme. Okay, weather, changing weather conditions are there. Okay, so the weather conditions are not consistent as they used to be earlier. So every now and then we come to know about some cyclone, tsunami, yas, right? So there are so many cyclones or typhoons and all which are coming up every now and then, which used to be once in a while earlier, but now they have become, the norm of the day. So what are the reasons that global warming, so many cyclones or tsunamis have become the norm of the day? What are the reasons behind it? The first and foremost reason is that now the earth is not hale and hearty. It's not getting that nutrition which should keep it hale and hearty. So what's the nutrition of the Mother Earth? What's the nutrition of the Mother Earth? The nutrition of the Mother Earth is greenery, okay? The green covering, the ozone layer in the sky, and green cover on the land itself. These are its, nutritional components. But we, the human beings, are so selfish. We forgot that it is the Mother Earth who gave us shelter. But what we, and it's the Mother Earth who gave us shelter and made us live with its creations, that is flora and fauna. Who were the first beings who came on this earth? The first beings who came on this earth were flora and fauna. We people came quite later on, but as soon as man came on this earth, he started thinking that he is the master of this earth, isn't it? Man started thinking that man is the owner of this earth. So man thought like, I am the one who owns this Mother Earth. And as a result of his all cruel existence on this earth, as a result of his dominance on this earth, he started considering to be the flora and fauna to be the ones who could be crushed at any moment. So as a result, today, what is happening, we cannot ignore it. And if we don't become careful even now, then very soon the end of the earth will come. Okay. So far, the environmentalists, they had been just giving us the warnings. But now that time of warning is over. Now already it is too late. But even if we wake up now, even then we can save ourselves. And saving ourselves means saving the earth. If our Mother Earth would be hale and hearty, only then we will be we'll be hale and hearty. Because our survival is ensured upon the existence of hale and hearty planet only. Right? So planet is sick. The reasons, the symptoms are global warming. Okay, glaciers are melting. Okay, water level is rising. Extreme weather conditions. So these all symptoms make us know that yes, planet is sick. It needs to be taken care of. Okay. So reasons we all know. What are the reasons of the planet having become ill? The reasons are our reckless attitude towards the Mother Earth. We never took care of our Mother Earth. We never bothered to look after the well-being of the Mother Earth. Okay, we looted. We means human beings. Human beings looted and plundered all resources from the earth. Earth gave us all. And we thought, like, we have to consume it all. Did the human being ever bother that we have to leave something for the future generation also? We people have enjoyed the greenery and all. We people have enjoyed all oxygen and all. But did we ever bother that our future generation would also require the require oxygen to survive? Did we ever bother that our future generation would also require the green cover to replenish or to get rejuvenation? No, never. So it is because of the reckless, careless, selfish attitude of humanity that today the Mother Earth has come to that condition where there is no scope for the future generations to enjoy that bounty which we people had been able to enjoy. Right? So this ailing planet, children, basically the writer is only going to tell us the present condition of the Mother Earth. And he also tells us, like, who is basically responsible for this kind of earth condition of the earth? Basically, it is a human being who is basically responsible for whatever wrong has been done to the earth. And third, the most important thing Nani Palkhivala is going to talk about is, he talks about in this chapter is, like, right now the biggest change is the change in perception of humanity. Now there is a change in outlook towards the Mother Earth. Earlier, we thought, like, human being thought, like he is the owner of the Earth. Okay? And moreover, the human being thought, like, Earth is a non-living thing. But no, now a new concept has come up, that is, like, Mother Earth is very much a living being. It has its own needs. It has its own metabolic needs. And we must take care of those metabolic needs. And we must take care of them. And we must respect them. Got it? So this is a new realization which has come up. And the another most important realization which has come up is, like, the Mother Earth, whatever the resources are there, they are not for us to be used and consumed. They must be used in sustainable manner. So the sustainable development, this new concept has been mooted by the environmentalists. So as per this new concept, like, the sustainable development has to be kept in mind. That means, like, whatever the resources we have right now, we must not consume them all. Yes, we must use them, but in a very optimum manner, so that the future generations do not suffer because of our overconsumption. Okay, so we have to leave a lot for the future generations also. Okay, so change in the perception regarding the needs of the Mother Earth, and change in perception regarding the dominance over Mother Earth. We are not the owner, we are the caretakers. We have not inherited this Mother Earth. We have borrowed it from our future generations. So if we have borrowed it from our future generations, it means that we have to take care of the Mother Earth and we have to return it to the future generations in a very, in that perfect manner. The Mother Earth should be kept hale and hearty, and that way we have to give it to the future generations. So no generation is the owner of the Mother Earth. Each generation owes the Mother Earth to the next generation. And that way only the Mother Earth would be retained or would be kept as a healthy one. Got it? So, and moreover, in this very chapter, the writer Nani Palkhivala talks about the various reasons for which the planet has become sick. And one of those reasons, as we have already discussed, is a reckless attitude of the human being, selfish attitude of the human being. And second, very important reason is overpopulation on this Mother Earth. So when man came on this earth, then everything, the whole earth was green. But when man will leave, the earth would become barren. Before the arrival of humanity, earth was green. And after the departure of humanity, the earth would become barren, dry land. That is what the human being will leave behind. Okay? When man came on this earth, the whole earth was green. And when man would leave the earth, the whole earth would have become barren, dry land. This is the you can say in crux of the whole chapter. So let's read it out. I'll be explaining the chapter. So here are a few words. They'll be all coming up in the language. We'll be discussing them all together. So the following article was written by Naini Palkhiwala and published in the Indian Express on 24th November 1994. And now we are reading this article in 2021. So how many years have elapsed since this article had been published? About 30 years. Less than 30, about 27 or 28 years. Am I right? So almost after 30 years, we are reading this article. So it means that the article which was published about 30 years ago, did it really bring that change in human perception? The answer will be no. Had the human beings been able to learn something from what the writer was saying, then today we would not have been sitting locked up in the homes because of the pandemic. Then we would have been, you know, enjoying our life as usual, had we been taking care of our Mother Earth. So this, the issues that he raised regarding the declining health of the earth continue to have relevance. So what he talked then, those things are still now relevant. Why they are relevant even now? Because no one bothered what he said at that time. Okay. So one cannot recall any movement in the world history which has gripped the imagination of entire human race so completely and so rapidly as the Green Movement, which started nearly 25 years ago. In 1972, the world's first nationwide Green Party was founded in New Zealand. Since then, the movement has not looked back. So here at the very beginning, the writer gives reference to the Green Movement, which started in 1972. So the Green Movement, which started about 50 years ago, because when article was written in 1994, then he says that Green Movement started about 25 years ago. And by now, this we will say that the Green Movement started about 50 years ago, because it started in 1972. Now it is 2021. So almost 49 years have elapsed since the conception of this movement called Green Movement. So the Green Movement was started in 1972 in New Zealand. And since that time, this movement has not looked back. Like Green Movement has been the talk of the town since then. It has been the main objective of the whole world since then. So the point is that environmentalists, they have been always warning about the declining health of the Mother Earth. That's why this Green Movement was started off in 1972 in New Zealand. Now, second paragraph, very important here. We have shifted our hopes irrevocably from the mechanistic view to holistic and ecological view of the world. So the writer says that now we have changed our understanding. Earlier, we used to have a mechanistic view of mechanistic view regarding the Mother Earth. What is mechanistic view? Like we used to think that Mother Earth has is something which would live as per our needs. Like what we want, what we can do regarding the Mother Earth, that is how the Mother Earth would be able to manage. So then human beings were very important for the Mother Earth. Okay. So now our perception has changed from mechanistic to holistic and ecological view of the world. So as per the holistic view of the world means, like if we want that our Mother Earth should be, now if we want that we should be hale and hearty, then we'll have to take care of each and everything of the Mother Earth. Maybe it's flora, maybe it's fauna, right? So if all species on this earth, if species regarding animals, birds, okay, so all whatever is related to the flora and fauna, that all must be taken into consideration. Only then the planet Earth would be hale and hearty and only then we would be hale and happy. So ecological balance. What is ecological balance? Like if for the survival of a human being, it's not only that only the oxygen should be there. In order to make us live well, the ecological balance must be maintained. It means that we must take care of all species of birds, of flora and fauna. So complete well-being of the Mother Earth should be taken care of if we want to live. So that is a new change in human perception for the last few years. But otherwise, earlier people used to think only about their own well-being. It is a shift in human perceptions as revolutionary as that of, as that So it is a shift in human perceptions as revolutionary as that economic system. One page is missing here. So here one page seems to be missing. Yeah. Yeah, here it is. So he says, like in the previous page, the writer told us, like this change in human perception is as revolutionary as the one introduced by Copernicus, who taught mankind in the 16th century that the Earth and the other planets revolved around the Sun. So he says, like now we have started considering that in order to make the human beings live well, we must take care of the ecological system, well-being of the system, or the holistic well-being of the Earth. Like we must take care of the whole Earth, including its flora and fauna. And that change in human perception was as revolutionary as was the concept given by Copernicus, because Copernicus taught us in 16th century that the Earth and the other planets revolve around the Sun. So Copernicus taught humanity that Earth and other planets revolve around the Sun. Got it? And before this, before what Copernicus said, before Copernicus, people used to think like it is Sun which revolves around the Earth. But it was Copernicus who in 16th century said that it's not the Sun which revolves around the planet, but the planets, including Earth, revolve around the Sun. Got it? And that is the fact even now. That is actually the fact. So when Copernicus gave this point, for the first time in human history, there is a growing worldwide consciousness that the Earth itself is a living organism, an enormous being of which we are parts. It has its own metabolic needs and the vital processes which need to be respected and preserved. So the point is, Copernicus said that Earth and other planets revolve around the Sun. What Copernicus said, that was a revolutionary idea. Similarly, now the revolutionary idea is that now that Earth is a living being and it has its own metabolical needs or vital processes. A human being has his own metabolic needs and vital processes. We human beings have our own metabolic needs. We have our own various, you know, vital processes, maybe the process, the respiratory process or all. So a human being cannot live, we cannot live if our all organs or if our all processes are not working properly. So the similarly point is, like, in order to make the Mother Earth live well, its all needs and processes must be taken care of. If Mother Earth needs enough greenery or oxygen, that should be given to it. If human being needs to have enough quantities of vitamins or proteins and all, similarly, Earth has also got its needs. Okay? And if we don't fulfill those needs of the Earth, then Earth will not remain healthy. So the point over here is that this is a new change in human understanding. Now human beings have started understanding that the needs of the Mother Earth should be taken care of. And this new change in human behavior is as much revolutionary as revolutionary was the concept which was given by Copernicus, that the Earth and other planets revolve around the Sun. Is that clear to you? So here Nani Palkiwala is only talking about the change in human perception. So what is that change in human perception? Can I ask anyone? What change in human perception is Nani Palkiwala talking about? Okay, Pragati, yes, better speak up. Pragati, you can unmute yourself. Raise hand first. Pragati, raise hand. Yeah. Now unmute yourself. Yes, Pragati.
Yes, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Yes, ma'am, we can think of the flora and fauna on Earth as analogous to the cells of human body, which are also living. Therefore, we can conclude that Earth is also a living creature with its own cycles and systems that need to be sustained and then must not be disrupted so that the systems can go on without any disruption.
Yes. So very well done, Pragati. So absolutely fine what you said. So the point over here was, like, we all needs of the Earth must be taken care of. But earlier, what was the concept earlier? How did human beings think earlier? They thought like the Earth, like it is we who need to be taken care of. Human being was selfish earlier. But now, because of the growing consciousness among the environmentalists or the people, we have started realizing that Mother Earth needs to be taken care of. And that also for ourselves. So, okay? So the Earth's vital signs reveal a patient in declining health. So the vitals, we have begun to realize our ethical obligations to be the good stewards of the planet and responsible trustees of the legacy to the future generations. So right now that it's very clear that our Earth is, Earth has become a patient in its declining health. So we have now realized that Earth has become a patient. Now that is very, very clear, no doubt about it, right? During this pandemic, we have even, this very thing has become all the more clearer, right? So right now we have become responsible, and we know that if we won't take care of this Earth, then nothing would remain there. So now we have begun to realize our duties, our obligations are the stewards of the planet and responsible trustees of the legacy to the future generations. So it is we people who have to be the responsible stewards so that we become the ones responsible, so that we become responsible to carry forward the legacy of this beautiful Earth for the future generation. So future generations must be kept in mind if we want the Mother Earth to survive well. The concept of sustainable development was popularized in 1987 by the World Commission on environment and development. So who gave the concept of sustainable development? It was given in 1987 by the World Commission on Environment and Development. So what is sustainable development, children? It is sustainable development means, like, number one, we must make the optimum use of the resources, but at the same time, we must not consume and finish them all. We must take care of the future generation, and we must leave something for the future generations as well. Sustainable development is using enough, but keeping something for the future generations as well. In its report, the World Commission in its report defined the idea as a development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations to meet their needs. So this is the definition of sustainable development. That is, without stripping the natural world of resources future generations would need. In the zoo at Lusaka, Zambia, there is a cage where the notice reads, "The world's most dangerous animal." Inside the cage, there is no animal, but a mirror where you see yourself. So children, there is a cage in Zambia, and outside it's written, like, here in the zoo, there is a most dangerous animal. And when you go inside, then you just see a mirror. So it means that who is the most dangerous animal on this earth? Man. That is, we people are the most dangerous animals on this earth. Thanks to the efforts of a number of agencies in different countries, a new awareness has now dawned upon the most dangerous animal in the world. So because of the efforts of many environmentalists, we people have started realizing that we are the most dangerous animals on this earth. And we people have started becoming a little responsible for the well-being of Earth. So he means human being, that is we. So he has realized the wisdom of shifting from a system based on domination to one based on partnership. So because of this change in perception, there is a change in, there is a realization of shifting from a system of dominance to the one based on partnership. So what is a system based upon domination? It was that when human being used to think that the earth is his. Earlier, human being used to think that he is the owner of the earth. That's why human being went for hunting, for deforestation, for killing fish, or for or cutting off all the, greeneries, whatever. So earlier, human being thought that he is the master of the earth. He dominated the earth. That's why he killed animals. But now, man has realized that he is not the owner. Rather, he is sharing the earth with the other flora and fauna. Okay? So if man has to live on this earth, then the flora and fauna also has to live on this earth. So now, we have realized that it's a system of partnership, not of dominance. Scientists have cataloged about 1.4 million living species with which mankind shares the earth. So man is sharing this earth with 1.4 million living species. Estimates vary widely as regards the still uncatalogued living species. So estimates keep on changing. So one estimate is, like, we share this earth with about 1.4 billion living species. But the estimate keep on changing because there are so many still uncatalogued species are there that biologists consider that about 3 to 100 million other living species still languish unnamed in ignominious darkness. Because there are biologists, they consider that there are more than 100 million of other species which are there, which have not been discovered so far. Okay, so they are still being neglected. Ignominious darkness means because they have not been discovered so far. We don't know that they are there. So they are being ignored. But there are about hundred of millions of species, 100 million species, which are there but not being counted. They are still languishing, being ignored. They are there but not being acknowledged, because we don't know that they are there, but actually they are there. So what does the writer only wants to say through these facts and figures? The writer only wants to say that human being was in great mistake. Human being was really committing a blunder by dominating the earth. Because how can this earth be only of man when he is living in partnership with so many other species? One of the early international commissions which dwelt inter alia means along with other things, among other things. So one of the early international commissions which dealt with the question of ecology and environment was Brandt Commission, which had a distinguished Indian as one of its members, Mr. L.K. Jha. So there was an international commission which was dealing with the question of ecology and environment, and in that commission there was one Indian, Mr. L.K. Jha. The first Brandt report raised the question, are we to leave our successors a scorched planet of advancing deserts, impoverished landscapes, and ailing